today we will speak something about the biological asset, like agarwood as an example. There may be cattle, maybe also consider biological asset, or maybe even beauty. Any ladies here? Yeah, all of them have beauty. You see, people have two eyes, no one nose. You have two nose? No one nose. But some will be look very beautiful. That may be somewhat biological asset, because they can have some income, like become very healthy or something. But let me also share something about the standards. I think about the standard of valuation, it doesn't mean that the long history country with valuation, we have better standard than the country with shorter period of valuation, like Thailand. We may know valuation maybe only 40 years, India maybe more, but some countries maybe even more than that. But it doesn't mean that the country we have valuation equation has more better standard or not. It doesn't mean so. Actually, there is no difference in the standards. If we value something, market value, it should be totally understood, because this is an economic term. This is engineering terms or something that people all know. If there are some different, maybe something very minor, something that maybe we need to discuss in detail about why it is different, maybe because of some different assumption, different understanding, and mainly different set of information. If we have different set of information, definitely we come into different value. And another big problem is because of corruption. If you do not corrupt, the figure should be more or less the same. It doesn't mean that if I value 1 million rupee, another guy value 2 million rupees, both may be incorrect, but it doesn't mean that both are correct. It cannot be. Like one may be correct, or both may be incorrect. Different opinions in a professional term may be 20% or 10% different from me, but it doesn't mean that totally different. If they are totally different in value, maybe because of corruption. Another observation that I talked with our gentleman from South Africa is that in our valuation profession, there are so many other professionals who like to influence in our profession, like accountant or in mass appraisal, maybe those computer guys, they may also want to get involved in mass appraisal, like, or maybe some other people like to get involved into our profession. Maybe they have no more job, they want to work in our field or something. I think to have standard or not, this one thing, definitely we do need to have some standards. But another thing is that more importantly than standard is the quality check. Like in Thailand or many countries, we may have examination to be a valuer, like a junior valuer, middle class valuer, junior valuer. Maybe we can value up to 1.5 million US dollar. Middle class valuer, maybe 15 million US dollar. And senior valuer like me, maybe no definitely. That maybe we have some examination, we have standards, but above that, we need to have examination, we need to have quality check whether they perform the work properly or not. If we do not have a quality check, maybe we just have a standard, a fake standard, or maybe a real standard, but not in existence. And more importantly, I think it depends on the democracy or democratic atmosphere, If everyone have participation, there will be some examination or maybe some cross-check. But if it is not democracy, no democracy, in internationally, locally, no democracy, just a domination, there will be no standards, or maybe just something vague, that is some contribution that is not related to BOS. So let me come back to the BOS. Valuation or biological asset. This is Agarwood. Anyone know Agarwood? Anyone know Agarwood? I don't know until last year, because I was appointed to do Agarwood valuation. So I'm also new. But if we want to value anything, we need to study the industry that is the thing. This is me. I have Chinese name because my grandmother moved from China. I don't know why she moved from China. She moved to USA. Maybe by now I may be Bruno. So I have Chinese name. And I'm also a member of the ICS and also IAO supporter organization, like the Espresso Foundation in the US. And also wrote a few books. This file is available in this computer, so you can download it later. This is my company, we do valuation. I didn't know that here you do valuation by individual. It is really cool. I like this idea. But in Thailand, we do valuation by the company, because we think the company will be more responsibility in the liability or something. It is individual, but individual may run away. In my company, I have 120 people working with me. And we value different properties. Recently, we also went to Brazil, or South Africa, like Lesotho or something, Botswana, or somewhere, to value the casino. And also here to be in casino for quite some times, so that we know what is doing in casino. Or even in massage parlor, come to Thailand, we have massage parlor. If you want to value massage parlor, maybe you have to be there for a few times, 10 times or something, to study. Tell your wife to go to study, not to play, not to, just to study. Bioasset, in this case, any trees or something, but it is not actually for bioasset. It is not like crops maybe every 3 years, 3 months, 4 months, or corn or something that is short life, but yet this is long life. So this is what we call the bioasset, because they can produce something further. It doesn't mean that after we chop down, it finished. There may be something further, or we can sell like cows. See, cows they can produce milk, not only the meat, milk. But don't say about cows, because cows may be the vehicle of what we are. Right? Maybe we say something like a pig. Yeah, that is something maybe happening. And in this case, this is the IAS 41, and also some authors that you can have a look what is it about the case. So you can see in further detail, this is a living animal or plants that you can produce income. You like an even human being. You see the movie Roots, if you buy and sell slaves can be also considered some sort of bioasset, because they can produce some income after the cost. Or even beauty. See, if you are beautiful, maybe you can do some job in the convention or conference up here in front of the booth, and every day you can earn around 10,000 rupees as a 50 or something. So that is something like that. And how to measure, you can see how to measure this in detail. You can read it yourself later. But in this case, we have to describe what is the bioasset. Like what we will tell you in detail in this case. That is the example, like sheep, pigs, cattle, or something, or direct cows, that is also bioasset, or trees in the forest. Agarwood, you may know that agarwood, this tree can produce something that is very good smell, good for Arabic countries. Arabic countries, they have a belief that they should not have aftershave or something by alcohol. It should be by wood. By alcohol, maybe like a liquor or something is sinful. So in this case, they use bioasset or this agarwood. And the age of one big agarwood that can be used in natural wood will be 100 years, 40 years, 50 years, or even 100 years. That is too long. So we have to produce this thing within 4 to 8 years. That is very interesting. So this is a cattle farm, so my yard, fair value. And you see that the fair value, one thing that is really similar to any case that is about the knowledgeable. If we have no knowledge, not knowledgeable, maybe we are cheated. And this is not considered the fair value. And also they will be willing seller and buyers, right? The Taj Mahal may be no willing seller, but there may be some willing buyers. Or big men, or maybe some willing buyers, but no willing seller. Or maybe the Emerald Buddha in Thailand, there may be some willing buyers, but no willing sellers. But there must be market practice. That is what we all understand. Okay. And in the cash flow, we have to understand what is the cost and what is the income that can be produced. You may know that agarwood, the trunk is available, and even the roots also usable. Every part of them, this tree can be usable. And in this case, we have to how to contract the price relevant, how to make the extract this sort of the value of properties. And they also cost to sell. When we value this sort of properties, the land and the buildings and every other cost incurred will not be, will have to be deducted, because that is not, we are not valuing real estate. We are not valuing the plant naturally to produce this food. We just value the biological asset. So that is what we understand. So first we have to acquire the biological asset, how to grow it, not naturally, and then how to develop it, like how to inject some medicine or something, and how to harvest, and how to get the crops sell. So what is agarwood? Oh, before I go on, allow me to do something. If you don't mind, I have a questionnaire for you. Maybe you can kindly, you have paper, right? Everyone have a piece of paper? Kindly put 9129, the number 129. How many? The Indian, our colleague from other country, no need.
Where is the view?
You see, number one.
Where is my view?
Let's say F5.
Sorry, thank you.
What is
that? Yeah, so you put number one to nine. Let me access this, and then let you calculate it, and then send back to you. Okay? Alright? No need to write the question. Just write an answer. Right? You put 29, please. Sir, you can help do something also. 29. Yeah. Number one, you can just write down. Don't copy each other. Don't copy it. Just write down. Say number one, please assess the Indian economy last year. Say, can is best, right? But it's very worse. In Thailand, maybe China, they may say 10 or something. India, maybe something. You may say 7 or 4 or something. Middle is 5. Right? Okay, kindly write up something. And after my presentation, it will go to collect your answer. And then I will calculate it. And then you have to look. Number two. Write down number two. Can you assess the overall Indian economy this year? 2017 is this year. Say 1 or 5 or 8 or 10 or something. Last year and this year. And what about next year? Number three, you may kindly assess the Indian economy next year. Do you think it is better than this year or not? Someone said that now it is a recession. Maybe you can say 4. Next year you think maybe 6 or 7 or something. Number 3, okay? Number 4 is similar. Number 4, please assess the Indian property market situation as a whole. Last year, number 4 is last year, like 2016. And number 5, 2017, this year. Is this year 2017?
Yes.
2017, what do you think? It may be 8 or something. And number 6, Indian property market next year. This year, if you assess 6, next year, if you say better, maybe 8 or something, you can write down. No copy. Don't look at your friends. Like when we are in high school or something. Number 7. Let's take a few minutes. Number 7. Which sector will go faster right now? Fastest right now? What is the hopeful or very promising sector? Maybe residential, or maybe industrial or commercial, like an office building or something. Maybe you can rank 1, 2, 3. Number 1 is what? Housing. Number 2, maybe rental apartments. Number 3, maybe shopping center. I saw shopping center here for eternity. Eternity, should last very long, eternity. But if there is another bigger shopping center come, maybe that eternity, your shopping center may gone. Okay, number 8, last one, before last. Number 8, if you can buy property abroad, if you can buy a house abroad, without your permission, without the permission of your wife or something, which country will you go to buy?
Thailand.
Zimbabwe. Thailand. Or maybe USA. Number 1 USA. Or UK. UK. Or maybe Africa. South Africa. Right now. There's 2. Last one. If this is very important, last one, if medical doctor you rank 10 as the highest or the best professional credibility, medical doctor. Okay, medical doctor. What about values? What do you rank?
10.
11? No, 11. 10 is the top, okay, 10. Values, maybe you can say 7 or 10, okay, you can say 10. Or someone may feel pessimistic, you may say 1. Don't let your friend see you put 1. Your friend may kill you. Or maybe 5 or something like that. Yeah, okay. So this is the questions. You've got to be ready. Okay, so we go back. 5 minutes. Oh. If my daughter has gone 15 minutes. I don't know what. Sorry. Okay, we'll go away. Okay, this is Agarwood. This is the inside of the wood. Look like it. The history is really long with the country. And you can see, this is the artificial one. I mean the one that we try to put something inside. You see, inside there are something that is the trunk is very white, but if we inject something inside, there will be something, you see, dark side. And that dark side can produce very good agarwood oil. Okay. And that is very expensive. Very expensive indeed. More expensive than gold. And the usage, maybe for drug, or maybe for ornament, or maybe for perfume, or even for food or something. The plantation, you see, as I told you, the tree may be beautiful within 20 years, 40 years, 60 years, or 100 years. So many people go to the forest and chop down the trees. That is very illegal. But here now they grow it, and within a few years they can harvest. So this is the growing of this. And they can, people who grow this can earn a lot. Okay. We have to take out the leaves of the branch, trimming or something. And this is the very important process. We inject something into the trunk so that they can produce some chemical things that will be very valuable. We call black gold. Black gold. And this is, we can study in detail for the, this tree is very prohibited by scientists. So this is what they, you see inside the trunk, very, very dark side, and that is very valuable. And then this tree, the oil will be more expensive than gold. And even the other things, they can also burn it so that they can produce very good smell. And the marketing, yeah, in this case, in the marketing, in this is in Thailand, we produce in many places. You see the products, here is the product. And you can see that they can keep it in different form of gift. Maybe you can, my president can give me some Agarwood for me. And you see, this is also some other products that in this case. The valuation, last thing is how to value this thing. The thing is we have to analyze the market whether there is a future or not. This market is over $10 billion or $30 billion. Very big and very stable market in the world. And this is the thing is how to produce this Agarwood oil. There's some technology that we have to study in detail. And because of the scarcity of natural supply, that's why we can do it and need. And this is really important. And low competition. Okay. And I give you the reference so that you can go and study in detail. And this is the valuation of timber. Timber, as I tell you, you just chop down once and there you go. And in this case, you can produce, it can be produced in different form. Not only used for the door or something, it's more valuable. Timber, you can use it like a gate, a door, or a roof or something. But this is more valuable. And this is Agarwood oils and several other products that can be sold and make money. In practice, first we have to see how they grow, and then we have to have in a way in the full Asian population. So this is depending on the technology of different companies that can be proved whether they can produce good or not. Instead of 100 years or instead of 20 years, they reduce the production time to only 8 years. 8 years only. That's why they can produce a lot of oil. And you see, this is when we conduct the valuation, we have to survey it. In Thailand, in Laos, in Cambodia, there are so many plantations like this in Indonesia or Malaysia. So this is the income approach that we use. We have to see what is the income projection, and then what is the cash inflow and cash outflow in details. So this is some example that we do, but I have to cross out all the figures, I'm so sorry. And in this case, there are something about land and buildings and also some other development, and then you have to take it out later. And the hypothesis of income, there are several types of income that can be produced. And they will produce in a different grading of the Agarwood. And the amount of production. You see, we should have the hypothesis of expenses. You see, there are so many expenses like nutrients, you know, pollution, and the revenue, and the harvest cost, and the wood processing, even the waste management, also the cost. Apart from that, we buy the tree from the people who grow it 4 years. And then we inoculation, inoculation, and then wait it for another 4 years and then harvest. So this is every 4 years we do this. And then this is the income that we can produce. And by this income, it is very valuable. As I said, the high is grab by grab is more expensive than gold. And this and something about the expenses, what we will spend for all the expenses that we need to study in details. Otherwise, we cannot value the properties. In every example, we need to, in every field, when we value, if we don't know the properties, we don't know the nature of the properties, we cannot calculate. We cannot just garbage in, garbage out. And this is also some other cost of expense. Last is about the cash flow that we should run the cash flow on annual basis and for 10 years. And then cash outflow, and what is the summary, and the present value, the value that we can harvest in year 12 or something. And then that is the, those years, we have to make it to the present value compared to the value of the trees today. So that is the value of the biological asset. In this case, so thank you very much. This is me. So, if you have a question, maybe you'll comment, but don't forget, we have some questions for you, so maybe you can kindly write up and you can put it on the table during the break. I will just go and collect it myself. Just put it on the table, don't put it in your pocket. Thank you very much. Namaste.